Hi Aries and welcome to your monthly predictions. We are going to talk about how month of April is going to be for you. Along with that, you can also watch, because these videos are coming a little early in the month, you can watch the March predictions also and see how much things have resonated with you and how much should you follow about the things that I'm telling you for this month. Month of April is a month where you are going to go on your soul path, you are going to go on your life lesson, and going on life lesson usually is not easy. At times it requires the bigger turn of events. And that's something that I see happening in your life. Though there is card of justice and card of wheel of fortune, it feels like if there was a struggle that you were putting in, if there was a struggle which was not letting you be in balance, there was a heartbreak, there was situations that you were feeling emotional about, then all of that is going to change and there is more balance that is going to come into your life. But you'll have to keep working towards balance. Also, a lot of communication is going to come in your life. A lot of people with a lot of messages are going to come into your life, and you need to be very careful. Read between the lines, be very careful, do the background check, and then only believe something or then only kind of react to these communications. Another thing, end of the month I see some structure falling down, so some major change happening in your life. But that major shift, that major change, that falling down is actually going to lead you towards making the right choice in your life, and that is why you'll have to have patience. If something happens that is happening for good, and you'll have to believe in that because it is taking you towards your life lesson. Now, one thing that you need to take care of is this month, if possible, avoid three-party situations. And when I'm saying three-party situations, number three is your number of the month this month, and it is for a reason. I kind of saw a lot of cards coming in twos, and the three number or five of swords, where there are three people and this person is picking up three swords, and two swords have fallen down. So this three and two has a significance in this month for you. And this month you need to take care of that. One, you're not kind of getting into tri-party situations, so avoid tri-party situations. Second, there is a possibility that you're already into a tri-party situation, so don't try to sort that this month, at least not in the beginning of the month. Don't get into arguments with people, and this month, as much as possible, be with yourself, be with your inner self, and accept what is there in your life. Because if you see, there are three cups here, and one cup is coming from out of nowhere. He's expecting this cup only and not looking at these three. So look at what is there in your life, look at how you can balance them, how can you move forward. And like I said, take care of this, because three and two are going to be very, very important this month for your life. If we talk about your health, though I don't see many issues with your health, one, there could be some dietary changes that might happen, and you might have to kind of put restrictions on certain kind of diets for yourself. Follow those restrictions carefully. You don't have to kind of not follow them. You have to accept them and follow them, and they are going to be important for you. Heart health is important, and some skin related issue or some skin irritation or allergy, something of that kind might happen. But it's like, if you take precautions, if you keep yourself balanced, things should not bother you much. End of the month, I kind of feel that there could be some kind of either falling or some kind of accident that's possible. So be careful. But at the same time, know that whatever the changes that come in this month, whether it is in terms of your health, in terms of otherwise in your life, they're coming because they want you to do, life wants you to kind of bring you to your life path, and you have to accept those changes, get into balance with those changes, and move forward. For your mental health, accept the situations as they are. It is very important for you, because if you take everything to your heart and if you start struggling with why these changes are happening or why these communications are coming, then it's going to be difficult for you. But if you understand that that is happening because it is meant to happen, it will be easy for you to kind of understand this life lesson. If you talk about wealth or money, there is of Pentacles, Seven of Pentacles, Knight of Pentacles. Money is not going to be a problem, and you'll be working towards having more money in your life. And also, if you're patient, you will get some kind of money gain, or some money will flow from some kind of investment that you've done earlier. But like I said, this month, one, don't believe in blindly, and just be very careful about whatever. If you're getting into a contract, any agreement that has money as a major value, ensure that you are reading everything carefully. Ensure that you're not putting your money just like anywhere. And if there has been a struggle where you were supposed to give somebody's money or somebody was supposed to give you money, that kind of might get initiated, but you'll have to have patience, because it doesn't mean that immediately it will come to you. Or if you have to give it, ensure that everything is written down clearly. So ensure that whatever you are settling this month in terms of money, everything is on paper. There is nothing that's happening verbally. If we talk about your love or relationships, this is the month where if you have been in any struggle with your relationship, there's a possibility where you take a decision and take it in the legal way, because there's a card of justice, and there's a possibility where you kind of walk away from a relationship or change the status of your relationship. But at the same time, your cards are saying that, one, avoid taking major stands this month, because life will push you towards it and it will happen automatically, but you don't have to push it too much. Don't get into arguments with your with people around you. Don't get into arguments with your family members or with your friends. If there is any struggle situation, any legal matter that has been there, know that you'll have to have patience. You'll have to keep working towards it. Whatever communication that comes your way, or whatever you communicate with your family members or with your life partner, ensure that you are not communicating in haste and you are actually weighing your words well. Also, accept the people that are there in your life with their faults, or however they are, accept them and appreciate them. Don't take everything to your heart. Also, again, avoid three-party situations. If you're into a relationship with somebody, be with that person. Don't try to get into a relationship simultaneously. And if you are into a three-party situation, you will not be able to sort it this month. It is going to be sorted in a different way, but then that's necessary for you to happen. If we talk about new people coming into your life, yes, new people might come into your life, but the stability will be a question. So if you can, just be with yourself, sort yourself out, and then look forward or look out for a relationship. If you're looking for a marriage or something, I would say that this month, if you can avoid it, it's going to be better, because stability is going to be a question with things this month. And for the baby birth, I see cards more kind of inclined towards adoption than pregnancy. So that's another thing that I see on your cards. If we talk about job or career, this month don't struggle too much and don't try to kind of get into arguments with your bosses, with your teammates, with people. Don't get into that zone that what you have is not what you deserve, or what you have is you want something else, you're waiting for something else. And if you don't have a job and you're struggling to get a job, don't get into that zone where whatever is coming to you, you're not accepting that because you think that you're meant for something different. Accept the things that are coming your way, accept the opportunities that are coming your way, because some will come, and keep on working. So don't look for immediate growth, don't look for immediate change, don't look for immediate situation or promotion or travel. Things will happen, but they will happen at their own pace. Don't try to push the things. And if there is a change that is happening, if there is something that is changing, you're given a project, you're given a work that you didn't want to do, ensure that you do it. Ensure that you pick it up. Ensure that you don't argue. Ensure that you don't think, don't get into that zone that it is not meant for me, because it is meant for you, and in the end it is going to give you good results. Also, this month, take very good care of your communication. So whatever is coming your way, whatever you are saying, communicating, read between the lines, going to be very important this month. If we talk about business, I think in business also you will have to continue working on the things that you're working. Ensure that you are completely compliant legally, because justice is there in the center. Ensure that you're not getting into arguments or fights with your partners. Ensure that you're not getting into a tri-party situation, not into three partners. And if you're getting into any kind of agreement, contract with regards to money, with regards to property, ensure that you read everything clearly. Everything is on the paper, because I kind of feel something is going to fall apart by the end of the month. Though, if you have patience, that is going to bring in new growth for you. And when that falls, there is something that is going to come out of it, which is going to change everything for good. So you don't have to get disheartened with that. But at the same time, know that you have to be patient. You have to continue working towards things. If we talk about students, for students this month, you might just feel that whatever you're doing, whatever you're studying, whatever you're putting your efforts in is not giving you the result that you want. And the cards are saying keep working, keep putting the hard work, keep putting the efforts, because there is something that is coming your way where you'll be able to make a better choice. You'll have to have patience, you'll have to communicate carefully, you'll have to read between the lines, you will have to accept the things that are coming in your life, whether it is a course, whether it is a competitive exam, and avoid fighting with people and have patience. Because before you make a choice, there is something that is going to be happening which is going to be drastically different than what you expected, and that will be the best time to make the choice once this event happens. So by the end of the month, make your choice. If we talk about soul path, this month says this is the month which will take you towards your soul lesson, which towards your life lesson. Accept the things that are coming into your life, accept the change that is coming in your life, and keep yourself balanced. Keep on working to keep yourself balanced. That's going to take you towards soul growth. And one of the most beautiful things when we learn our soul lesson is that our life starts becoming very beautiful. And this is the month that is going to give you that opportunity. We talk about chakra of the month. Chakra of the month is crown chakra. Crown chakra is located here, top of your head. The mantra is Ang. You can touch your tongue on the upper palate and say Ang, A-U-N-G, or you can just do a silent meditation. But whenever you do a meditation for crown chakra, please meditate for the base chakra or do the grounding. That is going to be very important. There is a lot that you're going to receive this month from in terms of energy. And if you do all chakra meditation, that is going to work out wonderfully well for you. But otherwise, even if you do this and practice grounding, you'll be able to kind of understand where your life is leading you. If we talk about mental exercises, the two cards that I have is man holding a heart, and then there is a female who's kind of standing with a flower, and it says appreciation. These cards basically are saying that it is very important to be for you to be comfortable with your own emotions and then appreciate everything that you have in your life, accept it. So the two affirmations for you is, I'm comfortable with all my emotions. I honor and express them in appropriate ways. I feel peace. This is first affirmation that you have. Second affirmation you have is, I choose to see and appreciate the beauty and value around me. I increase my gratitude every day, and I am attracting even more to be grateful for. And these affirmations are going to really, really help you this month. You need to kind of practice them. If we talk about number of the month, undoubtedly number 3 is the number of the month, and you have to remember this month. 3 is going to be important for you guys. Color of the month, any shade of purple, blue, silver, in terms of red also, red shades are also going to be good for you because you need to be grounded. If we talk about surrender message of the month, the first card says surrender comparisons with other people. It says keep your eyes trained on yourself, focus on your own strengths, attractiveness and power. So it is important for you to be focused on yourself rather than focusing on other people, what they are doing, what is happening in their life, why is my life like this. Don't get into that zone. Accept your life. Second, it says surrender to the wisdom of the body. Listen to your body's messages about a person or situations. If you feel physically drained or uncomfortable, be cautious. If you are energized and happy, move forward. Your body will tell you everything, but you need to be listening. That's important. If we talk about unicorn message, it says mysteries. Again, number 3 card, 21. It says explore the unknown and unexpected awaits you. And trust me, if you go through this zone in a positive manner, keep working on yourself, there is definitely unexpected good results that are coming your way. The wisdom message for you is buy the book. It's card number 11. It's buy the book, and it basically justice is number 11. It basically talks about major changes where you have to follow the universal law. So this card says the universe works within a structure of divine laws and principles that provides a framework for human experience and evolution. The law of abundance, the law of prayer, the law of karma, the law of attraction, the law of thought, the law of compensation, and the law of nature are only a few that are known. These principles create perfect order and operate with a kind of precision beyond human understanding. Even revolution has its place in universal law. Human beings in turn have their own laws and customs that vary from the culture to culture and family to family. Laws keep social order and govern behavior, reflecting an instinctive understanding that harmony is important. This is the time to learn these laws and conform to them rather than being a rebel and flouting them this when this card appears, submit to the structure and follow the rules even if they seem to be making no sense. Release resistance for universal laws will correct any disharmony. Open your eyes to the universal laws and it will be easier for you to go by the book this time. And trust me, universe is working out this month and you have to accept the things. What will happen if you follow the guidance and what is the angel message? The card says in Ace of Swords, it says a wonderful new idea. Don't allow bumps in the road to hinder your progress. Clear up communication problems with others. Have clear communications and keep moving forward. It is going to take you places. If you know somebody who is Aries, do share this reading because they will also undergo these problems. And if they know it, it will be easier for them to go through the month and actually get advantage out of it. What is the message for Aries? Guides angel. Message for Aries. Beautiful. Ace of Cups. Ace of Cups. It's a new emotional situation. It is basically the cup is overflowing. There is a dove who's coming out of this cup, and there is a plant or a leaf in the dove's hand, in the beak, sorry. But it is a beautiful card to talk about that universe is working for your favor. This is the divine gift. Whatever is happening, don't let your emotions overflow and don't let your emotions kind of take charge of the situation and you not getting the complete benefit of it. Be in peace and harmony with yourself. The more you are at peace, the more you are in harmony with yourself and the more you balance, the better situations or things will come into your life. If you want to know more than this, you can contact me for your personalized tarot reading through the Facebook link that's in the description box or through the comment section. You just have to write I want my reading. I'll share my number, we'll take it forward from there. Also, there are a lot of videos on my channel about soul journey, about soul growth, about everything, the positivity, a lot of things are there. If you get time, please watch those videos because they will help you kind of understand life, move better into better direction, and they are into very simple language, so they are easy to kind of understand. So if you can, do watch those videos, they will help you. And if you can, leave the comments and share the videos with everyone, because your comments are absolutely important for me. And if you can share this, or if you can subscribe the channel, that will be great for me. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you with the next month's prediction. Till then, take care of yourself. Thank you so much. Bye bye.